Coming up on Harvest, if you like hummus with roasted red peppers, you're going to love today's menu. Chef Randy Z prepares an easy-to-make veggie-wrap recipe. And in today's Motivational Monday message, Pastor Mark Lantz discusses the science behind happy thoughts. Also, Brian Bush is standing by in Jerusalem with an update on the latest news that's making headlines in the Middle East. We want you to stay with us because The Harvest Show begins right now.
The Harvest Show with Stefan Radlich, Valerie Lowe, Chuck Freebie, and Brian Bush from Israel. The Harvest Show, where faith makes a world of difference.
Good morning and welcome to The Harvest Show. So glad you could join us today. And I'm so glad to welcome my colleague, Stefan Radlich, back to the couch of The Harvest Show.
Almost didn't make it this morning.
Well, I'm sure you're tired, jet lag. How was the trip?
It was a great trip
down under.
We were down in Brisbane, Australia last week for the CMA, Christian Media Australia Conference. And they're actually announced that they're changing
their name. Say that again.
Christian Media Australia Conference. Every year they have an annual conference in the Gold Coast. This year's theme and topic was significance. So it was a great few days down there connecting with the heads of media, radio, television. They've got an incredible young youthful and vibrant division called Spark, which are young people that are involved in music and the arts, visual arts as well. And man, just powerful stuff coming out of Australia with respect to communicating the message of the gospel in a way that's relevant and engaging. The ultimate goal of one speaker was to have a cat video that explains the atonement. Now, obviously, that's a joke, but you know, just showing the power of social media and the fact that you know we can get captured by cats and pieces of toast, you know, and or whatever it may be, and then it'll take the world by storm. Can't we communicate the gospel in such a way, or the message of atonement, forgiveness, redemption, life in Christ, in such a way that it becomes something that's captivating globally?
Okay, so that kind of reminds me of this story that I wanted to do, and our executive producer said, well, maybe we should check into that just a little more
before you do it.
It's called, there was a dog, his name is Prophet, and his owner goes around to churches teaching Christians obedience through tricks and different things that this dog can do. The dog's name is Prophet, so... So this this meeting that you went to, would it be equivalent to the National Religious Broadcasters?
In many ways, it is. It's much smaller because Australia, which big country. I mean, it's almost the size of the continental United States. And someone could Google that for me. Tell me if I'm I know it's somewhere right around there. Can't remember if it's larger or smaller. But there's only 28 million people in the whole country.
Wow.
And so, you know, it's a much smaller convention and conference, but there's a growing movement amongst the Christian community to engage in media as an effective way to really reach out, not just to their nation, but around the South Pacific as well, and around the world. And so the president of NRB happened to be there for the week as well. And Bayless Conley was one of the featured speakers, Eric McTaxis from Salem Radio and Socrates in the City, a syndicated national radio program across the United States. And Darlene and Mark Check were there. Darlene won a Lifetime Achievement Award. And Feed the Hungry was there as one of the many organizations that were represented. So we've got a great opportunity to connect with a bunch of radio stations as well as television. Australian Christian Channel carries The Harvest Show, Harvest Light, and live from Studio B. Got to catch up with that bunch and connect with them as well. So it was good all around.
Well, tell me, did you hear, was there a lot of buzz or conversation about the death of Prince? You know, since that has happened over the weekend, trending for sure, he was put to rest, actually cremated, and there was a memorial service held for him. But that has also struck up a conversation about faith. Mm-hmm. So just, you know, because it was said that, you know, he was a Jehovah's Witness and went around, you know, from door to door sharing his faith. And it struck up a lot of conversation about what Jehovah's Witnesses believe, but more importantly or equally importantly is this whole conversation about faith in Christ and what have you. Just any conversation about that going on?
No, that kind of happened as we were closing up. Australia's actually a day ahead. So it really messes up your time. Yeah, so 14 hours ahead of Eastern time here in the United States. And so by the time that news happened, mm-hmm. you know, we were already pretty much dismissing for the conference over the weekend.
Okay, well, then maybe you were in flight when all of this was unfolding. 392,000 people have signed an online pledge to boycott Target after the retail giant said that transgender employees and customers could use the bathroom that corresponds with their gender identity. Mm-hmm. And so this is this was announced, and there is a hashtag boycott Target pledge. And what these people are saying basically is you can have a unisex bathroom.
Right.
There's no need to create a transgender bathroom. So yeah. This is the conversation that's going on. It'll be interesting to see if this will kind of translate into dollars and affecting mm-hmm. sales with this retail giant. Mm-hmm. Your thoughts on that?
Didn't hear about the boycott, but I did hear about Target's decision.
Right.
And, you know, similar to what's happening in North Carolina, mm-hmm. For me, the issue boils down to, it's one thing to have unisex bathrooms or family bathrooms, or, I mean, one whatever, that's fine. But what Target's saying is that if you're a man, they're going to allow you to use a women's bathroom in their store. And if you're a woman, biologically, they're going to allow you to use the men's bathroom in their store, which is similar to the North Carolina brouhaha. Mm-hmm. The opponents of it, of the legislation or of the ruling, say that this is discriminatory. But North Carolina is saying, well, no, you can have a unisex bathroom in a facility, but we're not going to allow men to use women's bathrooms, and we're not going to allow women to use men's bathrooms, regardless of what you think or feel you may be sexually.
Right.
If you got the proper chromosomes, you're either a man or you're a woman. If you got mm-hmm. the body parts, you're either a man or a woman. And as a woman, I would imagine.
Oh, are you kidding
me? You guys should be up in arms over this one.
Yeah, I am. I mean, there's no way I'm going into a bathroom with a man. I don't care what you believe. I personally would not feel safe to do that.
Yeah.
I go into their bathroom, there's a man, there's a woman. Everybody's waiting to use the. I just couldn't do it. It just makes sense to me that you could have unisex bathrooms, or you could have their family bathrooms.
Right.
I go throughout airports as
yes.
we travel. We
sure.
see family restrooms all the time.
Mm-hmm.
But to go, and then for a woman to go into a man's bathroom, I'd imagine that would make you feel uncomfortable.
Yep, it sure would.
Okay.
Yeah. Now, with regards to this story mm-hmm. here, is this nationally Target's making that? Decision?
Yeah, this is a decision.
Wow.
Yeah, this is a decision that's wow. going around nationwide.
So are you going to shop at Target or just not use the restroom?
Well, I mean, you know.
Definitely not going to use the restroom.
Yeah, I'm not going to use the restroom there for sure. This is from the Christian Post. We want to make it very clear that AFA does not believe the transgender community poses this danger to a wider public, to the wider public. This is what Wildman, this is a spokesperson who said about in favor of this decision.
But it's not just about danger. It's just
no.
about the issue of propriety and the feeling of, you know, you're kind of, why can't normal people have their safe zones too?
Yeah,
you know, especially when
right.
it comes to bathroom.
Yeah, all I want to do
rooms,
is
rooms.
Go to a female bathroom with other females, you know, where other females go.
Yeah.
I just wouldn't feel comfortable. But that's just my opinion. We want to know your thoughts, and we welcome them. Join us on Facebook, join the conversation on Facebook, Twitter, and send your emails directly to the set of Harvest at liveatlesea.com. Don't go anywhere. The international news is next.
The Harvest Show is getting a high-definition makeover. Starting Monday, May 2nd, you'll get the same hosts you know and love on a set that'll make you say, wow. The new half-hour Harvest will continue to give you the motivation and inspiration you love on a brand new set you'll enjoy. Everybody's working hard. Yes, even Valerie. So mark your calendars for Monday, May 2nd, and get ready for The Harvest Show in HD.
Monday, April 25th, 2016. I'm Bob Nagel, in for Chuck Freebie with this check on international news. United States President Barack Obama joined German Chancellor Angela Merkel on a tour of an industrial fair in Hanover on Monday. The two leaders listened to presentations from German and U.S. traders at the fair, which is the largest industrial technology trade show. President Obama also announced the deployment of an additional 250 special operations forces to Syria to help the local troops trying to dislodge Islamic State group extremists. Obama touted recent gains against the group, saying the additional troops would help keep the momentum going in that area. President Obama also cited the importance of Europe being diligent about its defenses and said that sanctions against the Soviet Union should continue. The Nepalese Prime Minister on Monday announced the reconstruction of heritage sites in the capital of Kathmandu that were damaged by last year's devastating earthquake. Prime Minister Kaja Prasad Oli offered prayers to begin construction of a 300-year-old temple that was heavily damaged on April 25, 2015. 600 other monuments were also damaged in that earthquake. Work is set to begin on Monday with over $4 billion on hand for the project. Nepal has been criticized for delays in the renovation, but government officials wanted to be sure of the financing and the schedule for the project, which could take over a year and a half. The incumbent pro-European Union populist candidate swept Serbia's parliamentary elections in a landslide on Sunday, leaving the pro-Russian nationalists far behind, according to preliminary results. The triumph by Prime Minister Aleksandar Vučić's Progressive Party means Serbia will continue on its path toward European Union membership, despite opposition from right-wing parties which seek close ties with traditional Slavic ally Russia instead. The election was held 2 years early because Vučić wanted to mandate, to continue for his efforts. The hopes are for economic and social reform for Serbia. Malbik Station in the heart of the Belgian capital reopened on Monday after it was closed following the extremist attacks on Brussels last month. The station was shut down for more than a month after the twin attacks on Brussels on March 22nd, which killed 16 people and wounded many more. Two Americans died in that attack. The officials in Brussels said the attacks did not do any structural damage to the station, but it created aesthetic destruction to the ticketing area between the street and the subway levels. A tribute wall has also been erected at the station where people have written heartfelt sentiments for the bombing victims. And Britain's Prince Harry laid a wreath during a dawn service at Wellington Arch in London on Monday to mark the start of the Anzac Day commemoration in the United Kingdom. Thousands of people waited in the dark for the start of the ceremony, which marked 100 years since the day was first marked in the British capital. Anzac Day has been commemorated in London since the first anniversary of the Anzac landings at Gallipoli in 1916. The service honors the service and sacrifices of New Zealand and Australian countrymen and women in all wars. Officials from the UK, New Zealand, and Australia laid wreaths at Hyde Park Corner as well. And that is a check on international news. I'm Bob Nagel. Coming up next on Harvest, Pastor Mark Lantz will help you start your week off right with his motivational Monday teaching. Then stay tuned, because a little bit later, Randy Z will be cooking in the studio and it smells great already. I can't wait. Harvest continues after this.
Got Facebook? Follow The Harvest Show.
Comment and share your opinions on current events.
Watch the most inspiring guest interviews right here.
Watch my weekly video updates from Israel.
Facebook.com/The Harvest Show. Like us today. Well, welcome to Monday. Boy, I love Monday. We can start the week off together. We can get motivated to make this the absolute best week of our lives. So I want to ask you a question this morning. Would you like to become smarter? Would you like to be healthier, be in better shape, maybe have more energy to do the right things in your life? And I know the answer to that. Of course I would like to. I want to be smarter. I want to have more life, more energy. So I want to share a couple of things with you on this Motivational Monday to be mindful of. That means to be mindful, to pay attention as we move into the week. So pay attention to these things. Be mindful of them. The first of which is this: be mindful of the moment. In other words, pay attention to what's going on around you at this moment. Too many of us, We spend our entire life on autopilot. Our mind just wanders from thought to thought. We have no control over where our thoughts go. We sit through mindless meetings. We don't remember anything about that meeting. We even have mindless conversations with our spouse. They don't achieve intimacy. They don't draw us closer together. You're driving down the road. Your mind is somewhere that you have no clue. Listen, it's time to take your mind off of autopilot. Be intentional about where you are. Be intentional about what you're doing at all times. In fact, right now, right where you are, look around you. What's around you? Be in the moment. You know, one piece of advice that I try to live by is this: wherever you are, be there. Not just physically, mentally, and emotionally as well. So be mindful of the moment. Secondly, be mindful that you are what you eat. You know, many of us, what we do is we put food in our mouth simply because we feel bored, we're stressed, we're depressed. Friend, food has been given to us by God as an energy source. Food is there to give you the fuel that you need to keep going throughout the day. So just pay attention to what you're putting in your body. It's going to affect your energy level, your thinking skills. It will affect your mood, how you feel emotionally. You know, these high-performance cars, they demand requiring a high-performance gas. So if you want your body to perform at a high level, put some high-level food into your body. Watch what you eat, because you are what you eat. Thirdly, be mindful of this. Be mindful of your sleep. You know, sleep is one of the most underrated activities that we partake in every day. Because when you sleep, your body, your brain, it rejuvenates itself. And if you don't get enough sleep, your body, your brain cannot fully recover and be ready to take on the day. In fact, they say the average person needs 7.5 to 9 hours of sleep per night. But the average American gets about 6.8 hours of sleep, which puts them in sleep debt. And when you're in sleep debt, then you're living a sleep-deprived life. So get to bed earlier tonight. Get the sleep that you need so you've got more energy, so you can think clearer. Just flat out be more productive tomorrow than you were today. So the last thing I want you to be mindful of on this Monday is this. Listen up. Be mindful to listen up. You'll be amazed at what you learn, not just from what you hear people say, but also from the person who is saying them. The next time somebody speaks to you, stop the chatter in your head. Actually pay attention to what they are saying. Not only will your relationship with them deepen, but their respect for you will increase as well. So there you have it. Four things to be mindful of this week. Get your head in the game. Start paying attention to the important things of life. And friend, I guarantee your life is going to go to the next level. I want you to have a great week, have a great Monday, but be mindful of the most important things.
Right now, millions around the world are cut off from the gospel, but you can reach them with your gift of support to LeSEA Broadcasting's shortwave radio ministry. To thank you for your generosity, we'd like to send you Dr. Sumrall's mini book, Roadmap for Life. You can request your copy when you sow your seed this month by calling 1-800-365-3732. That's 1-800-365-3732.
Do you sometimes wonder what life would be like if you had the energy to do those extra things you want to do but just can't? Maybe it's to go for a walk after dinner or spend your Saturdays playing with your kids. If you're tired all the time and have decided that you just always will be, guess what? You don't have to be. With Mineral Concentrate from Making Healthy Choices, this fulvic acid electrolyte mineral formula promotes maximum cell function while sparking your body's electrical conductivity. What does that mean? Well, most people say they've never felt better. The best part is it's only $29.95. And if you call now, we'll even pay to ship it to you. So dial 1-800-965-2345 or go to mhclife.com. This electrolyte formula promotes dependable, solid energy day in and day out. So call the number on the screen. Do it for your spouse, your kids, your friends, and most of all, do it for you. Call 1-800-965-2345 or go to mhclife.com. It's time for life.
In Uganda, thousands of children pour across the border, fleeing the terror and violence taking place in South Sudan. Many have nothing but the ragged clothes they wear. They're weak from hunger and struggle to survive. Today, you have an opportunity to change the life of one of these refugee children from Sudan. For just $72, you can provide food, comfort, and security for a child for an entire year. $144 will take away the pain of hunger and introduce two children to the joy of full life that comes from knowing the love of Jesus. Please call 1-877-769-9270 today or visit feedthehungry.org. Please act now. These children need your encouragement. They need to know they are not alone. Please call 1-877-769-9270 to help a child know how good a full life feels.
And someone who knows and makes others happy with knowing what a full life feels like is Mr. Randy Z. Chef Randy Z has been with us for a long time here on The Harvest Show. We're so glad he could join us today. And today you're going to be creating some hummus for us from scratch, as well as sun-dried tomatoes and a wrap, and really some great summer foods here.
Well, light, fresh. I mean, look at the colors, look at the freshness. Yeah. There's nothing in here that's going to hurt you. We're just going to make a simple hummus. I mean, if you get hummus in the store, it's $5, $6, $7.
For a little tin, a little jar.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. It's really not that hard to do. So I got a blender or a food processor.
Mm-hmm.
And all you have to do is get one can, which is a 16 ounces of your
garbanzo
beans.
Chickpeas. Yeah, you can use dried ones too if you want to soak them overnight, I'd imagine.
Yes, beans are very economical in our country, but nobody wants to play with the dry ones because they don't know how to hydrate them and cook them and everything. So we have one can of that, and then we have our tahini here, and we're going to put in a third cup of that.
Now, what is tahini?
Ground up sesame seeds.
Ground up sesame seeds.
And that's all she wrote there. Okay, and then we got two cloves of garlic minced up here.
All right.
Because it's morning, we need a little garlic.
Gotta have garlic. Gotta have garlic in the morning.
Oh yeah. I'm gonna throw that in there. Get this locked down. Turn her on. Make some noise.
Now, is that a special blender of any kind, or just a regular food processor?
We'll chew that up for about a minute. There.
Okay.
Then we're gonna have you make a wrap for yourself with all the selections we have here.
Amazing selection of colors here. Your greens and reds and yellows and oranges. I had heard recently that you kind of want to make sure that your diet, that what you're eating every day, you got some color in there. It's not all one color all the time.
Yep. You've got to, what's fresh? It's vibrant, it's fresh. Now I take this screen because we have seeds in here and I don't want to break a tooth, but we're going to put a third a cup of fresh lemon juice in there.
All right, so you got the chickpeas, you got the tahini, you got the garlic
and
mixed up, and now some lemon.
Now some lemon juice.
Mm-hmm. So it's one lemon, half and half.
It'd take about 1.5 lemons to get the third cup out of there because I'm not strong enough to squeeze them all that hard. And I like to cut into them so they squeeze out easier.
Yep. Okay.
Okay, and then you can see there's
that's your
10 seeds in there,
pulp.
And I'd want to find one of those in the back of my tooth. And then we have a white balsamic reduction. We're going to add just a little bit of that to it.
White balsamic.
Yep, so we got 2 teaspoons of that.
Oh, yeah, look how thick that is. That's not just vinegar, that's a reduction.
No, she's reduced down to nice
syrupy.
Candy.
Yeah.
And then we're going to take some fresh basil here.
Okay.
Just about a tablespoon worth of that. Drop that in there.
Tell you, folks can't kind of get this through TV, but it just smells absolutely wonderful.
Roasted red pepper in a can, or it comes in a can or a jar. You can fire roast your own if you like. This is convenient for us here. And we're going to do a half a cup of that in there. And then for the sun-dried tomato, we got it right here.
Okay. And it's a concentrated paste.
Yep. It's just basically a pesto-style paste. 2 teaspoons of that. And then we're going to grind that all up.
Wonderful.
And you need to start perusing our
blends
of everything all here, why this goes.
Yeah, get that going there. And I can smell we've got some yogurt, we got some feta cheese, and then all these greens, dill, parsley, mint, broccoli, cuke, carrots, all this stuff. They're making a veggie wrap. What is this right here? Is that your basil?
Basil.
Okay. And that over there is?
Watercress.
Watercress. It's almost like a parsley, but not quite, really.
Yeah, it's more of a peppery, mustardy flavor, mustard flavor. And this was cilantro here.
Cilantro.
And then we have some lime, if you want to squeeze lime. We've got some radish. And then it's just your favorite vegetables. As the menu would say, the recipe is just select your favorite vegetables, what you like, and then you can make a wrap. So we pureed this down.
All righty.
Get that over here.
That's your hummus.
And that is just as simple as it gets. You puree it even a little longer if you texture, you want the smoother texture. And I think out of everything in here, we'll have about $2, $2.25.
I was going to say, just out of curiosity, I was going to say, you may or may not get the cost here down per unit, but yeah, you're right. A little tub of hummus could be anywhere from $3 to $6, $7 if you go to your local supermarket, and you made a whole bunch of it for just a couple dollars.
Yep. And what I like is what you see is all that's in it. There's no preservatives, there's no additives, there's nothing that's going to be in this to preserve it on that shelf for that long a period of time. So over there, you can set that.
Oh, right in the center.
And we've got ourselves a plate over there ready to go.
Get a little crudité there, very nice. We'll get that moving.
And then you want to, we're gonna show here now just a simple vegetable wrap. You can put that up in the front there.
Yep.
So you can take and select any of your favorite vegetables. This is you now, you're eating
this one. Okay, I'm doing this one.
Which wrap would you like?
Do I get to use some of the hummus?
You could give you all the hummus you want.
Yeah. Throw me some hummus in there.
I'll get it out of here. So
now, Randy, you've been at The Crossing, which is a great educational ministry here in our South Bend area, Mishawaka and Michiana area, and you're the culinary instructor.
Yes, I am.
That's relatively new. It's been, about a year maybe now?
October I started.
October?
And I'm very happy with the program. We just moved to a new location in South Bend that is at the old Madison Center on the river. We have a beautiful kitchen there that was partnered up with the owner of Dave Matthews. He's been doing a great job helping us.
Not the musician.
Kids. Not the musician, no.
Okay.
Everybody says that. I'm sure he's heard that so many times that he just doesn't even hear it anymore. So we take the high school kids and teach them their life skills and their culinary arts to take care of themselves.
Now, are these kids from just general public high schools around the
They're
area?
They're from the Crossing Educational Center.
Crossing Center,
which is basically the last chance for the troubled kids or kids that have made some mistakes to get their education.
Right.
And we do faith-based education, job training, get them set and ready to go out in the real world.
I know it's incredibly successful. There's like a 90-something percent success rate of these kids that are in some trouble.
Yes.
Once they go through the Crossing program, which kind of helps build them a spirit, soul, and body, and gives them some life skills like culinary arts, they just thrive and do so well.
Yeah, and you know, building up their confidence and letting them understand that someone cares about them is a big factor in that also. You know, I only have 8 students in a class, and I have a different class. They alternate days, so I have 2 different sets of classes. I have an intermediate group that have been through my program already that are advancing in, and then my life skills class is the class that I'll have tomorrow.
Wonderful.
So they're doing well.
Good, good. Now we got summer coming upon us. In fact, my wife and I, we cracked up the grill last night because it's just that time of the year and it's getting nice out. Some quick grill tips for our friends that are watching. I mean, this is nice cold. You don't have to heat up your house to make something
this
like this.
This is great on a hot day where you're hungry, but you're really not hungry and you don't want to get...
Let me get a little bit more of that.
the kitchen all heated up.
Right.
This is really good. So here you go.
This is going to be a messy affair, I hope.
It's
not.
Messy.
Yeah.
There you go. Take that how you want.
Beautiful.
Grill tips. You know, keep your grill... When I say clean, I don't like scrubbing mine down to shiny metal. You just want to get the chunks off it. That's a good season there. You know, keep your grill seasoned.
Yeah, yeah.
And then, you know, a lot of people have problems with their food sticking. They think they need to oil it down. It's basically a heat issue.
Mm-hmm.
If it's not hot enough, it's going to stick. But you can take an old rag and some vegetable oil, and you can just
kind of
one time down your grill to assist that situation.
Yeah.
And other than that, I get a lot of questions about the sauce. I'm always burning my barbecue sauce on my chicken. Well, you don't put it on to the last 10 or 15 minutes.
Okay.
A lot of people baste up their bird and stuff the whole time,
the whole
and then it's
time
black.
It's just,
you know?
Yeah, getting
so
charred.
That grilling tip would be that your sauce is going to caramelize with the sugars in it.
Yeah, yeah.
So go ahead and you put that on the last 10 minutes or so in an indirect heat area. So that's a good one.
Awesome.
There's so many of those. I mean, it's nice outside. We can start cooking again outside when I come back and finally get rid of that cold weather. So you're going to roll that?
I'm going to roll it. Let me ask you, any tricks? Any tricks to roll in your tortilla?
Well,
you know, you go to XYZ place and,
I mean,
they have that thing all packaged up nice.
Well, you know,
when I do at home, I've got to make sure I'm holding it on a level.
A lot of them go here and then go. It just depends what you have in it. Like one of my daughters likes one end open. Some people can go both this way and have a smaller one. And then you always have to tuck the corner in. And then it's easier on these if you heat them up a little bit.
Okay.
Yeah, they can become a little more pliable.
Okay.
But there you go.
Yeah, and actually, may I borrow your knife, Chef?
Yes.
I'm going to cut this in half for you, Dean. Or
no, if my students are watching, see, he asked permission. They know not to mess with my knives.
Oh, no. You never touch a chef's knife without permission.
True.
Okay. Mm-mm.
So.
Is that a burrito?
Hey, Dean.
Is that a breakfast burrito?
This is
it's a hummus.
Healthy veggie wrap.
Oh.
Yeah, healthy.
Veggie wrap. Can you do the veggie wrap? Boom. Chick. Boom. Chick. No, okay.
That's good.
Okay.
Yeah, boy, did I miss you, Dean.
Yeah.
What are these?
Bagel chips.
Bagel chips and a wrap?
Bagel chips, crudité, simple, yep. Wonderful, healthy, good for you.
Don't double dip the chip either.
Don't double dip the chip. And it's, the best part is, good food doesn't have to cost you an arm and
that's
a leg.
Crunchy.
You make it at home, get some simple ingredients, if you have a food processor, as they say in Australia, Bob's your uncle, things are good, it's gonna work for you. And you can eat healthy, you can eat well. Remember to keep the colors in there. That's
I'm
good
eating.
For your body, good for your soul as well. And just enjoy some food
the
with family.
The recipe's on the website.
Thank you, Dean.
I can hear things.
You can hear our producer.
I can hear the producer.
All right.
With food in your mouth.
If you'd like to find the recipe for build your own veggie wrap and make your own red pepper roasted sun-dried tomato hummus at home, you can go to The Harvest Show on Facebook. Like us there. We got a whole bunch of great information that comes up on our Facebook page each and every day. Randy, want to say thank you for joining us today. Always good. Coming up later, Pastor Charles with your prayer requests. Going to pray for Dean as well. Pastor, don't forget about that. We're going to be right back to hear from Brian Bush in just a minute. Thank you, Randy.
Yes, sir.
If you are among the thousands who love the teaching of Lester Sumrall, then you should have the two-volume set of The Treasury of Lester Sumrall. Written in Dr. Sumrall's easy-to-understand style, you'll feel like you are getting a Bible school education. There are 732 individual readings, one for each day for two whole years. These beautiful devotionals will also make a wonderful gift for your friends, family, or even your pastor. Order yours today.
Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. Again, I tell you that if two of you on earth agree about anything you ask for, it will be done for you by my Father in heaven. Let us then approach the throne of grace with confidence, so that we may receive mercy and find grace to help us in our time of need. Here at Prayer Line, we devote ourselves to prayer. 24 hours a day, we are on watch and thankful for every call that we receive. We see each caller not only as a prayer partner, but another opportunity to see God move and lives changed. If you have a need, please call us at 1-800-365-3732.
In the last 15 years, friends like you have helped send over 700,000 Bibles to anyone who requests a copy through our Spread the Word ministry. God has certainly been working powerfully through your support. The book of Romans says, "How beautiful are the feet of those who bring good news." That's why we're so thankful for your partnership to help us take the best news of all time to more of those who are desperate to hear it. It costs just $5 to send a Bible to someone hungry to read it in Africa, South America, or many other places around the globe. Through your generosity, many thousands have already read about the saving grace of Jesus Christ. And with your support, we look forward to helping fulfill Dr. Lester Sumrall's vision of reaching the untold billions yet untold with the gospel.
Catch up with Brian Bush, LeSEA Broadcasting's correspondent in the Middle East. And Brian, good to see you today. Let's forego the news a bit. As I see, this weekend was Orthodox Palm Sunday there in Jerusalem. How did that go?
Hi, Chuck. I'm always glad to do that.
You know, there were a lot of Greeks, Egyptians, Ethiopians. More and more Russians are showing up every year, I've noticed. But it was festive. They follow a similar pattern as the Western churches, or the Catholic Church does, in their organized procession that leads from Bethphage on the other side of the Mount of Olives, comes across the top of Mount of Olives, down into the Garden of Gethsemane, and across the Kidron Valley, and up into the Old City. They follow that same tradition, and it was a joyful amount of people there, singing and giving praise to God, proclaiming Jesus as King.
Brian, now you know we celebrated Easter a few weeks back here in the United States. Why are Orthodox Christians, or why is the Orthodox calendar, celebrating it now?
Right. Well, there are two main reasons. First of all, the calendar. The Orthodox Church follows the Julian calendar, and pretty much the rest of Christianity uses the Gregorian calendar, what we're used to in the secular world. There's a 13-day difference between those two calendars, with the Julian calendar being 13 days behind. The other reason is that the Orthodox adhere to the rules set forth in the first ecumenical council held in Nicaea in 325 AD that requires that Easter must take place after the Jewish Passover.
That actually makes a lot of good sense. Looking ahead to the end of the week, Brian, I know you've spoken about the Via Dolorosa procession on Good Friday. Do the Orthodox follow that particular tradition going down the Way of Sorrows?
No, not really. It's not in any organized sense. There are more and more Orthodox groups, I have noticed, who follow the Via Dolorosa and venerate at a few of the stations. The issue there would be that a lot of the Via Dolorosa stations are not actually found in the gospel accounts. They're extra biblical. But the Orthodox do tend to stop and venerate at those which are found in the New Testament narrative. And of course, the Via Dolorosa ends at the Holy Sepulchre. The last couple of stations are found within the Holy Sepulchre itself. So again, that elevates the church and the atmosphere of worship as one comes to Calvary and understands what it was that Jesus Christ himself had to endure, our sins and the sins of those whom he came to save, there on the cross, and what it took to get him there to that point.
Brian, here again in the U.S., there are several Orthodox communities who celebrate their Easter with the Western Church, not the Eastern or the Orthodox. And to many, that seems like a good testimony, a good idea, because after all, Christ's resurrection occurred once. What do you say to that?
Well, that's right. There's only one grace. There was only one sacrifice, and there's only one way to eternal paradise in the presence of God, and that is through Jesus Christ and the sacrifice that he has made for us. And I suppose a good verse to remind ourselves of is that chapter, actually, in 1 Corinthians chapter 12, talking about unity and diversity, where Paul talks about the different parts of the body and how we all glorify God in that way, that when we work together, we're moving towards his kingdom. And I agree with you wholeheartedly. There was one crucifixion, one placing inside the tomb, and one resurrection from the dead. And we are viewed as one church by God in our diversity, whether it be ethnically or theologically. Yes, there are differences where we do need to stand upon the scripture and how we understand it. But as a whole, that grace that is given through Jesus Christ is given to us all because of his great love for us. And that's what we celebrate this coming weekend with the resurrection here in Jerusalem. Although it happened once We celebrate it twice over here.
All right, Brian, great to see you and have a wonderful week there. Look forward to catching up a little bit later on this week as well. Hey, listen, a reminder that Brian gives us here on The Harvest Show exclusive content from Israel, but it's only available on The Harvest Show Facebook page. You want to make sure that you like us on Facebook, get access to all that. And while you're there today, get a hold of the recipes that we're posting online from Randy Z. Now let's head over to Prayer Line, where Valerie and Pastor Charles are standing by.
And welcome to the International Prayer Line, where prayer goes up from this place 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And the person in charge of all of that prayer and orchestrating and organizing intercessors and volunteers is Pastor Charles. Pastor Charles, I mean, the work continues even though we take a break and go take off on the weekends. We have intercessors here.
Yeah, well, sometimes we come back over the weekend when it comes to Prayer Line.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah, because
oh, okay.
Sometimes, you know, we have a tendency that sometimes some of the people, you know, Valerie, actually get sick. And
okay.
We have to have substitutions for them. And sometimes it's so last minute that we can't hardly get anyone. So myself and my assistant, Kay McIntosh, you know, we have to come in and kind of take their places. And so sometimes when they call Prayer Line, they literally get Pastor Charles.
So the work of Prayer Line is never done.
Never done.
What do you have
never
for
done.
Us today?
Today we're going to be talking about the prayer requests of some of those ones. We're trying to get that family, the home structure back together. And a lot of the husbands and wives are having difficulties in the home. And we want you to know that we're praying for you. But at the same time, God is able. We have Jill in Canada. Jill calls us from up in Canada and says, I started a new job today and my car broke down on me. And as I look to my husband for support, he informs me that he's leaving our marriage for another woman. She says, please pray with me that this is God's will and not just our flesh. And then we have Sheila in Texas. Sheila says that my husband and I tried to work it out, and he feels that we can't make it work. I'm at a place where I just want peace and to leave this marriage without being bitter.
Wow.
All right. And please agree with me that God helps me to stay focused on him. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And then Rachel in Illinois, Rachel says that my husband has gone back to his old lifestyle, Valerie. Yeah, it says he's hanging with the old crew and visiting bars. Oh. Says he's drinking. His drinking has risen to the level where he could become alcoholic. She says, please pray with me that I treat this as it deserves as I listen to the Lord. And then finally, we have Donnie right here in Indiana. Donnie says that my wife and I have been going through a couple of things lately, but never thought I'd come home and she'd be gone with the kids. She says, please pray that they are safe and that they return.
I think we probably get more prayer requests about marriages and than almost anything else.
Lately, it's been that. Even a lot of times the finances are contributing to some of the marital problems.
Right.
Yeah, so finances.
The prayer requests sound so desperate.
They are.
The people are desperate at there at the let in, you know, they don't know what to do. They've thrown up their hands. Yeah. And that's a signal of surrender, and that's the best place to be in, to surrender it all to Christ. So, Pastor
Send
Charles, would you pray, please?
Sure. Father thank in heaven, you. We thank you today, Lord, that they are indeed calling Prayer Line, Father God. They're looking for agreement in prayer, but in actuality, they're looking for you to step in. Father, we're asking you today that you would indeed step in, move on their behalf, and deliver them from their situations and conditions. And Lord, we know, Lord, that when you decide that things are going to get done, then they get done. And Father, we're just tapping into that spirit right now, Lord, and we're asking, Lord, that they be covered, that these families, Lord, those ones who have walked out of their marriages, those ones who have forsaken their vows, those ones who have deserted their children, Lord God, that you would touch their hearts and allow them to see it for what it's worth and to know that you're not in approval with all of this. And Father, we'll praise you and honor you and give you all the glory in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. So if you need prayer, that number is 1-800-365-3732. You can send in your prayer request to prayer@lesea.com, worldharvest.com, and 61300 Ironwood Road, South Bend, Indiana, 46614. And World Pulse Festival is coming up. It's July 15th and 16th, 2016. But let's take a flashback to World Pulse Festival 2015 with Sidewalk Prophets. Take a listen.
I wanna live like that. Rich Mullins. My deliverer is coming. My deliverer is standing by. Yeah.
These days, reading your Bible is as easy as opening an app on your phone or doing a quick internet search. But how do people in developing countries hear the gospel when they don't have access to television, the internet, or Christian publications? The answer for many is shortwave radio, technology that's accessible to millions and ideal for broadcasting God's word to areas where missionaries simply cannot reach or aren't permitted to travel. We're so thankful for your support, which has helped continue the work Dr. Lester Sumrall began 70 years ago. Through your gifts and prayers, we continue to transmit God's word to every major continent in the world through shortwave radio, helping to reach a potential 20 million homes through this powerful technology. Through the support of friends like you, the good news of Jesus continues to be heard by many living in the most difficult to reach corners of the globe. And we thank you.
Today is your day. This is your moment. Life is calling. It's time to get back that extra spark that you've been missing, and it's simple with Mineral Concentrate, an all-natural trace mineral product designed to promote energy and focus without sugar nor caffeine. Call 1-800-965-2345 or log on to mhclife.com. Today is your day. It's time for life.
Right now, millions around the world are cut off from the gospel, but you can reach them with your gift of support to LeSEA Broadcasting's shortwave radio ministry. To thank you for your generosity, we'd like to send you Dr. Sumrall's mini book, Roadmap for Life. You can request your copy when you sow your seed this month by calling 1-800-365-3732. That's 1-800-365-3732. And as you can see on your screen there, we've got something we want to send to you as you support LeSEA Broadcasting this month, especially towards shortwave radio. Free with a gift of any amount, Dr. Sumrall's booklet, Roadmap to Life. What highway are you on? Do you know your destination? It's a great little refresher and a guide to helping make life count. And in fact, this was taken from Dr. Sumrall's book of that title, Making Life Count, Making the Most of Every Day. We've used these in the ministry for people that are just coming to faith in Christ to get a good jump start on the roadmap to their future and success and their fullness of life in Christ. But for all of us, it's always important to kind of refresh and stay aware of the important things, the priorities and the principles that help us get along God's road for us. And so it's really, whether you're a new believer or not, we want to send this to you as you help support the ministry this month. And this month we're focusing on shortwave radio, which reaches out around the world right here from the United States and from Palau in the South Pacific through LeSEA Broadcasting, reaching over 190 different nations.
That's right. I don't know people in 190 different nations, but when I give to the ministry of LeSEA Broadcasting, I am able to help reach those people because it takes money to run this type of technology, Stephan. It's very expensive. And because the technology is older, we have to do repairs. I've actually been to the facility, the shortwave facility in South Carolina, got a chance to see some of the curtains or the antennas, those huge curtains.
They're several hundred yards long
that broadcast the gospel around the world. And it's like if one antenna goes down or one curtain shuts down, that could be Africa that's impacted by that. So listeners in Africa won't get the message because that antenna is not working properly. And that's why we're asking you to come alongside and help us to, you know, proclaim the gospel, the good news of Jesus Christ. You know, I often say that, you know, I have five sisters, and when we hear of a good deal, we call one another and we share the good news when there's a sale going on. And it's just like that here. We're sharing with you the good news of Jesus Christ. We're able to reach people in places like North Korea. We would never be able to probably go there, Stephan. No. But because we can send our money and proclaim the gospel through shortwave, we're able to reach people. That's why it's significant for you to call now. That number is 1-800-365-3732. You know, only what we do for Christ will last. One day, whether you believe it or not, we're going to stand before Him and give an account for all that we've done for Him. Whether our works are made of wood, hay, or stubble, you know, it's going to be tried by the fire. So let that be something that you know, that's given to your account, that you help to proclaim the good news of Jesus Christ through the ministry of shortwave radio and through LeSEA Broadcasting. You know, Dr. Sumrall was a man before his time. We often say that. In fact, Dr. Sumrall is the most popular person on the Harvest Show. His teachings
on the broadcasting network.
That's right. And he's gone on to be with the Lord because his word is so powerful.
Yeah. And with that support this month, as you help with shortwave radio, again, you can be confident that you're touching lives all around the world. It's amazing to think that we have heard from people in over 190 different nations who've been blessed by the ministry of shortwave, who write to tell us the signal that they're getting and what kind of programs they're listening to, and to share what God's doing in their heart and in their life, to ask for prayer, to got questions about the scripture and the word of God. They hear about Spread the Word and they ask for a Bible, and we're grateful to be able to send those Bibles to our shortwave listeners. But this ministry would not happen without the faithful support of friends and partners just like you. So today, take a moment, think about it, pray about it. See what the Lord would have you to do to help us continue reaching the untold billions yet untold through the ministry of shortwave radio. And when you call that number, 1-800-365-3732, that, as you know, is also a prayer line number. And so if there's something going on in your home, in your life, in your business, in your heart, that you just want to reach out and see the Lord do a miracle or get involved in a special way, we'd love to pray with you about that as well. So you can give us a call. You can also go online to help support shortwave radio by going to www.lesea.com. Safe, secure, easy way to sow into shortwave radio online there. And again, with any size gift this month, we'll send you Dr. Sumrall's booklet on Roadmap to Life. I want to thank you for joining us here on The Harvest Show. We'll see you tomorrow.
The Harvest Show is getting a high-definition makeover. Starting Monday, May 2nd, you'll get the same hosts you know and love on a set that'll make you say, wow. The new half-hour Harvest will continue to give you the motivation and inspiration you love on a brand new set you'll enjoy. Everybody's working hard. Yes, even Valerie. So mark your calendars for Monday, May 2nd, and get ready for The Harvest Show in HD.
You know, there are so few things in this world that you can count on anymore, especially when it comes to our financial future and planning for retirement. We live in a dynamic world defined by change, but when it comes to securing our retirement income, we want stability, not uncertainty. And that's why I consistently talk about charitable gift annuities. A gift annuity provides a safe and steady income stream which is fixed for life, and you are investing into changing lives for Jesus Christ at the same time. If you are over 49 and a half years of age and you have at least $10,000 in a savings account or CD, call us today. Let us show you how you can have at least one form of retirement income that you can count on. When you lay up your treasure in heaven, you can count on it being there, waiting for you. So call us today and let us help you have a secure income for the rest of your life.
The Harvest Show is produced by LeSEA Broadcasting and is viewer supported by people just like you. Thank you for inviting us into your home today.